I don't dance on Sundays.
Look at him, because that's all you're going to see. He's harder than a rock, and he can't be stopped. You suck a step to the side unless you want to get
down here embarrassing.
The boys from the hood are on the MIC.
I'm getting funky.
Bitten out the lyrics, J.C. Ice and Whoopi G. Clarence Mason is the boss. Cross the T's and dot the I's. He tells the truth, the whole truth. He never tells a lie.
Well, tag team action, and this
could be a wild
affair. Goldust and Miguel Perez certainly infuriated.
With great justification
over what happened this past Monday on Raw.
How can they fight a whole nation? One nation indivisible under Peru with liberty and justice for nobody.
Arena with a total combined weight.
And we are ready to go here. Savio Vega and Miguel Perez pairing off as our crushing Goldust. And this match getting underway in a furious manner.
And you'd figure the two old friends, Savio Vega and Miguel Perez, would make a beeline toward each other. With friends like Perez, he don't need enemies.
Perez, a great second-generation star, James. And, of course, Perez's father, a former tag team partner, the legendary Antonino Rocca.
That's right, Rocca and Perez as a team sold out the old Madison Square Garden on many occasions back in the late 50s. And I understand that this Miguel Perez has inherited all of his father's talent and more. But you know the reason why Perez has come to the WWF. He was friends with Savio Vega during their days together in Puerto Rico. He feels that Savio Vega has turned on the Puerto Rican people. He came here to confront Savio, to try to swerve him back to his way of thinking. But Savio Vega told Miguel Perez, the Puerto Rican people never did anything for me. Now I'm a member of the Nation of Domination.
Tag has been made now, and the monstrous Crush, who certainly doesn't like to be referred to as a jailbird, in the ring, headbutting Goldust. And Goldust certainly seems to be a step or two, perhaps, off his game with the absence of Marlena.
But, whoa! He's not a step off there! He is not a step off there at all! He caught Crush with that big right hand!
And there's a lateral press, and Goldust, not enough to keep her down. Marlena is now at ringside, I see.
She's come out just now. Evidently, she saw that the team was in need, because it's obvious that this stalking woman, whoever she may be, that's been preying on Marlena, has got both Marlena and Goldust upset. They're usually the masters of the mind games, but in this case, their minds are frazzled at the hands of someone else.
Crush showing his power, just manhandling Perez back into the corner. Another tag has been made. Yes, indeed, that Amazonian-like lady. And because my mama's watching in Oklahoma, I will call her a lady, but I guess that really remains to be seen. Nice move there. Foot clock and then a drop kick.
You got to watch Perez. Here it comes.
And Perez, there was a somersault punch by Miguel Perez. A suicide-like maneuver. But Perez putting his own body at risk to try to gain an advantage. That's certainly worth another look here, James E.
The somersault plunger catches Savio Vega right in the chest. And Perez is a legend, a high flyer in his native Puerto Rico, as well as all over Japan, the Caribbean, and South America. I'm glad we get the chance to see him, but we may not have the chance long after that encounter with the turnbuckle.
Man, that's a heck of a way to be introduced to a turnbuckle. And Goldust having to be restrained by the official. In the meantime, we've got a Central Park-like mugging going on here between the Nation of Domination and and Miguel Perez here, making his Sunday morning Superstars debut.
Well, here is the telling point of who's the team and who's not. Crush and Savio Vega have teamed together, Perez and Goldust. It's their first time, and it's good single competitors.
Look out.
Oh!
Great wrestling maneuver.
Oh, man. I'm just going to say, as good single competitors as Perez and Goldust may be, they haven't teamed together.
There's a cover. I think we got your point.
Just trying to get it out.
Marut certainly has his tag team working very well on all cylinders here. And Perez tossed outside into no man's land. And again, well, look at this cheap shot attack.
Whoa!
Savio Vega getting that unfair advantage. Vega's so tenacious. And when you talk about tenacious, you got to talk about Stone Cold Steve Austin to some extent. Austin live. Uh-oh, look out. One, two, and, well, that's going to cause it for a break. Perez was in the ropes. No thanks to Savio. Stone Cold Steve Austin live from the WWF studios tomorrow night right here on USA as a part of the big blockbuster 2 hours from Berlin, Germany.
Wait a minute. I thought after what happened last time he was in the studios, when he called all that chaos, they weren't going to let him back in again.
Well, I'm sure that he was reprimanded for that and has been warned to be on his best behavior. And look at those kicks. Oh, strong kicks right to the ribs and lower abdominal region of Miguel Perez.
Welcome to the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. Perez.
Savio Vega, an amazing athlete and a very accomplished street fighter. And there's a choke. Nothing secret about that maneuver.
He's got a brand new attitude and a brand new nation, new nationality.
Folks, don't forget this Friday night, the WWF Live in Buffalo, New York at the beautiful new Marine Midland Arena. This Saturday afternoon, the Gund Arena in Cleveland. This Saturday night, Cobo Arena, Detroit, Michigan. Great live WWF action 1 week from today in Springfield, Massachusetts at the Springfield Civic Center, probably named the Ed Cohen Civic Center before long. And a crush off balance, and crush up very quickly, but he was off balance there. And went down, and now Perez is paying for it. And by the way, next Monday night, special Raw anniversary celebration in Worcester, Massachusetts at the Centrum, the 200th episode of Raw Live from Worcester next Monday night.
Well, Mr. Perez is going to have to get up, but there goes Goldust around. He and Savio are involved in a beef. And Perez is going to have to get out from under crush some way.
Miguel Perez is in big trouble. Is it over? One, two. Perez just barely able to hang on, and we'll be right back.
The World Wrestling Federation Rewind, brought to you by Full Metal, the album, the entrance themes of all your favorite WWF superstars.
I think the Headbangers are going to wish they went on back to the
Oh, forget about it.
Whoa.
Animal and Hawk back in the World Wrestling Federation and looking for trouble.
That was the World Wrestling Federation Rewind.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Press continue to work on Miguel Perez. Certainly, we are looking forward to the big live WWF event in Madison Square Garden on Sunday, March 16th. And I got a feeling Ahmed Johnson's got a huge score to settle with Savio Vega on that evening in MSG. Sunday, March 16th, is going to be a wild one.
Well, Ahmed's got a big score to settle with the entire nation. And as a matter of fact, we're going to hear from Ahmed tomorrow night on Raw concerning the challenge Farouk made for the Chicago street fight. And I don't even think Ahmed Johnson can fight an entire nation, especially in a street fight.
Pile driver.
Wow.
Crush overpowering Miguel Perez and wasting some valuable time. And Goldust with a stiff kick right to the ribs, interrupting the count. And no tag was made. Savio Vega coming in illegally.
Hey, it's only illegal if you get caught.
Miguel Perez may be getting ready for a TKO.
Whoa.
Same thing that happened to Sugar Ray Leonard last night in the fifth round, losing to Hector Camacho.
Ooh. Well, I'll tell you what, this Savio Vega, I can't wait till tomorrow night to see the three championships on the line. We talked about Bulldog against Owen on Raw. We talked about Rocky against Vader for the Intercontinental title. And also, Sin takes on Mankind.
That's big. That gets changed
that's
a lot
big.
Of things.
Yeah.
You know, there's no guarantee Psycho Sid's going to be the WWF champion in 3 weeks at WrestleMania. Oh, my.
A guy like Mankind on his tail.
Yeah, there's a lot of other guys hot on his heels, like Bret Hart. And what about Vader? I mean, there's a lot of folks that will have an opportunity to change the course of time between now and March 23rd in the Rosemont Horizon.
The title picture has been in such chaos here the past several weeks. Everybody's geared up. Everybody's trying to get a place at WrestleMania 13 on March 23rd. Everybody's going to do what it takes to be in a position of power by the time that day rolls around.
Miguel Perez may be on his last legs here.
Whoa!
Look at the power of Crush. A 6'8", 300-pounder with just an unbelievable strength. And the slam there, rather elementary after all that power. Leg drop right to the face. And the end should be near for Perez. One, two, and... Oh, Crush picked Perez up.
Wow. I've got to say, this Perez has lived up to his advanced billing. We heard how good he was. We heard he was a legend. He showed us that. But he's had two big, bad men on him for a long amount of time. Wait a minute. He's got something left. Perez.
Oh, the DDT. Jade's of Jake the Snake Roberts here with that DDT. Nice move by Perez. But the smartest thing Miguel Perez can do right now is to make a tag.
He's trying to, and so is Crush. Both men need to get that tag. And Crush has got it. Kid Perez.
There's a tag. Tag has been made. Goldust now. And Savio Vega. And Goldust quickens the pace and strikes suddenly and severely with a clothesline. Goldust showing his strength, slamming the 300-pounder.
Goldust is rested. He's fresh. He's taking on both members of the Nation of Domination, and he's winning.
Goldust to the right hand. Goldust, Savio Vega are the two legal competitors in this tag team matchup. And a crush from behind. Here comes Perez. The referee is rapidly losing control here.
This thing is out of control. These guys are wild. And look at Perez. He's trying to get some payback for what they put him through. But the referee's telling him he's got to be out. Goldust and Savio are the legal guys.
Goldust now with a cover. Goldust, wait. Hey, wait a minute.
Whoa.
Crush has got a steel chair and just nailed Goldust with it. The referee didn't see it. Can you? He should have heard it. Hey, ref.
One, two, three. He got him.
Just a bank robbery, and the referee asleep at the wheel here. The Nation of Domination win this thing with the help of that steel chair.
If Perez hadn't been in the ring and the referee trying to get him out, then the referee would have seen the chair. It was Perez's. Wait a minute. Perez has the chair.
Miguel Perez has got a chair.
Look out.
Ooh. Perez. Shot and
what
an arm in the face. Miguel Perez wielding that steel chair. Perez has dented the steel chair.
He's